This is Sparta!
Shalom. Skahan tells the doc. This is Right Knowledge for Vale. I'm going to continue on with Yakub, the Big-Headed Scientist series. We're going to talk about Crossing of the Burning Sands now. Netflix, it showed you that these people know the truth, right? So Netflix had a series called The Burning Sands. And I'm about to teach you where they got that from. That came from us, our people. Crossing the Burning Sands, see, Yakub's made devils were driven out of paradise into the hills of West Asia, also known as Europe. And they were stripped of everything but language. They walked across that hot, sandy desert into the land where long years of both trouble and joy awaited them. Now, when a person is a Moor, is a Mason, when they want to become a Shriner, they have to cross the Burning Sands. And they start reading from the Quran. I'll stop right there. So Yakub's graphic devils, they walked across the hot sandy desert into the land where long years of both trouble and joy awaited them. But they finally made it. Not all, many died in the desert. Once there, they were roped in to keep them out of paradise, to make sure that the righteous people who live along the borders of the East and the West Asia were ordered to patrol the borders to keep Yakub's devils in West Asia, now called Europe, the EU, and the rope, so that the original nation of the Asiatic man, the original man that they call black, could live in peace. And the devils could be alone to themselves to do as they please, as long as they didn't try crossing the east border. The soldiers patrolled the border armed with swords to prevent the devil from crossing. This went on for 2,000 years. After that time, Moses was born. The man with whom Yah, Allah, would send to these exiled devils to bring them again into the land of civilization. What is the duty of a righteous man to civilize the uncivilized? Before we take up the first 2,000 years of the devil exile on the planet, let us not lose sight of what and how they were made, and of the God who made them, Mr. Yakub. Since we've learned that Mr. Yakub was the original man, the Asiatic black man, the maker, owner, queen of the planet Earth, father civilization, God of the universe, God of the universe. You heard what I told you? You understand what I told you, Richard Birch, God of the universe? You heard what I told you, Clean Like Lenny? God of the universe. Since we've learned that Mr. Yakub was an original man, the Asiatic black man, the ignorant of our people may say, if Yakub was a black man and the father of the devils, then he was a devil. That is like when saying that the horse is as much a mule as the mule, now in cipher, or that an orange or a lemon is as much as a grapefruit as a grapefruit. They were all genetically engineered. You understand what I'm talking about? And that's the same thing that Yakub did. Now, you people, you will believe right now about human cloning, but you think this story of Yakub is far-fetched. So you want to determine which mysteries you want to accept. And just because your mind is not ready to accept it doesn't make it untrue. Understand that. Heed the knowledge. They're not alike because the grafted is no longer original. Just what we've learned, or rather are learning from this divine revelation of our enemies, the devil's answer. We are learning the truth, right knowledge, which has actually been kept a secret for 6,000 years concerning the Albinoids, mankind. Certain things I can't, certain phrases I can't use because of censorship, who have deceived us. We've learned what is meant by the Bible symbolic teachings that they were made from the dust. This only tends to come to convey the idea that they were created from nothing, which means the low and the humble origin of such creation. Again, we learn who the Bible in Bereshit, aka Genesis 1 and 16, is referring to in saying, "Let us make man." This us was the 59,999 original men and women, making and grafting them into the likeness of or image of the original man. Now that they are the same but have the ways of a human being, they are referred to as mankind, not the original man, but being a made like the original in the sense of human beings. In the Quran, throws a great light on the truth of the creation of this pale mankind that my teacher referred to as devils. O mankind, surely we created you from a male and a female. It's chapter 49 and 15. This makes it very easy to comprehend to why it is referring to what mankind. Surely we created man from sperm mixed with ovum to try him. So we have made him hearing and seeing. It's chapter 76 and 2 in the Quran. Inasmuch as these chapters have further reference to the spiritual creation of the last messenger, it is equally true that they refer to the physical creation of mankind. In another place in the Holy Quran, we've created man, and now he as an open disputer. See, Yakub's race of devils were exiled in the hills and the caves of West Asia, now called Europe. What? Europe. Huh? The U and the rope. They were without anything to start civilization and became savages. They remained in such a condition for 2,000 years. No guidance, no guide, no literature. They lost the knowledge of civilization. The Albinoid, the power, taught me that some of them tried to grab themselves back into the original nation, the black nation, but they had nothing to go by. A few were lucky enough to make a start and got as far as what you could call a gorilla. In fact, all of the monkey families are from this 2,000 year history of mankind in Europe. Don't cut my knowledge, God. Heed the knowledge. Now you can think it's funny all you want. Being deprived of divine guidance for their disobedience to mankind of mischief and calling bloodshed in the holy nation of the original people by lies, they became so savage that they lost all their sense of shame. They started going nude as they are doing today, and they're leading our women to be on social media nude with their clothes off. That's uncivilized. Those are the ways of a savage. Our women has become savages, emulating mankind, mankind's woman, in the nude and glorifying it because she's uncivilized. But my duty is to civilize an 85er. And if she would listen, I could raise her from a dead level to a living perpendicular. I'm God. Peace, God. So the so-called Negroes are in these very same acts today. They became shameless In the winter, they wore animal skins for clothes and grew hair all over their bodies and their face. All other wild animals, they became light. See, in those days, they made their homes in caves and hillsides, coming out of the Caucasus Mountains in Georgia, Russia. Mount Seir. See, there's a whole chapter devoted to them in the Quran. Again, they're spoken of in the Bible. They had it very hard trying to save themselves from being destroyed by wild beasts, which were plentiful at that time in Europe. Being without a God, they started walking on their hands and their feet like animals and learned to climb trees as well as any animal. At night, they would climb up into the trees. You can read the book of Job 30, verse 5, and Job 30 and 30, carrying large stones and clubs to fight the wild beasts. They would be prowling around in the night to keep from eating their families. Their next best weapon was the dog. And you walk around with dogs and you think that's something that we did. That was their animal, the dog. Now only you want dogs. Huh? Why you love dogs so much? They said his man best friend, now in cipher, is mankind's best friend. Understand who you are. Are you God? Are you mankind? I need you to listen because I'm advocating this. I take you to the book of Job 30. Well, watch this. Job 30, verse 5. They were driven from among men. They cried after them as after a thief, to dwell in the cliffs of the valley and caves of the earth and in the rocks. It's right here in the Bible. It's right here. Among the bushes they brayed, under the nettles they were gathered together. They were children of fools. Yeah, children of base men. They were viler than the earth. And now, am I their song? Yeah, I am their byword. You've allowed mankind to come and rule over you. You become savages. Our women are uncivilized. They walk around nude and naked. And they think it's righteous. What you want a woman like that for, brother? You better civilize an 85er. But first you have to allow Kahan tells a doc to teach you. I am not of this world. It is time that I begin to reveal to you who I really am. Now you think it's funny all you want to. I was sent here to civilize you. I'm not no ordinary guy. June 17 and 16. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. HaMashiach said that. HaMashiach said to mankind and John, Yakanah 8 and 23. Then he told them, you are from below. He was talking to mankind, and I'm from above. You're of this world, and I'm not of this world. Uncover my knowledge, God. 1 John 4 and 5. They are of the world. That is why they speak from the world's perspective, and the world listen to them. Many of you cannot hear Kahan tell the doc because you are of this world. You become of the world of mankind. You're uncivilized, but I'm here to civilize an 85er. Have I been here so long and you've not known me? Have I? You're not of this world when you come into a certain knowledge. Remember what I told you? Yakub 9, 15, verse 19 reads, "If you are of the world will love his own. But because you are not of the world," I'm not of this world, "but I have chosen you out of the world. Therefore, the world hateth you." A lot of you hate Kahan Tazadah because of this knowledge. You envy me, but you could never be me. This was given to me by Yahweh, Yahuwah, Adonai, the Supreme. Back to Yakub crossing the burning sands. Their next weapon were the dogs. They tamed some of these dogs to live in caves with their families to help protect them from the wild beasts. At the time, the dog held a high place amongst their family because of his fearlessness to attack the enemies of the master. Today, the dog is still by mankind, the Edomites, and is given more justice than some of you so-called Negroes, and is called man's best friend, but is really mankind's best friend. This comes from the cave days, and the serpent was lifted up. After 2,000 years of living in a savage, living like a savage, right? 2,000 years living like a savage, the Most High raised up Moshe, or as you say in Arabic, Musa, to bring mankind again to civilization. Who are you talking about, Kahan Tazadah? They call them the white race. There's no such thing as the white race. To take their place as rulers, as Yakub has intended for them. Musa, became their god and their leader. He brought them out of the caves and taught them to believe in the Most High. He taught them to wear clothes, how to cook their food, and how to season it with salt. What beef they should kill and eat, and how to use fire for their services. Moses taught them against putting the female cow under burden. He established for them Friday as their day to eat fish and not to eat meat, beef on that day. And fish is the main menu on Friday in many of the Edomites' homes today. They're so evil, so savage, that Musa had to build a ring of fire around them at night. And he would sleep in the center of the ring to keep the devils from harming him. They were afraid of fire and are still afraid of fire today. The Most High, through his messenger, told Tazadok, one day Moses told them he was going to have fish come up from the sea. That so, tomorrow we will have some fish. And so, on the next day, the fish was there. Moses had a boatload sent up from Egypt. Moses said, "See, the sea came up last night and brought us fish." One of the savages was a little smart, and he said to Moses, "Where's the water?" From then on, Moses recognized the fact that he could not just say anything to them. He had a hard time trying to civilize them. Once they gave Moses so much trouble that he took a stick of dynamite, went on the top of the mountain and placed them in a group, and went back to get those who were giving him the most trouble. He said to them, "Stand there on the edge of the mountain, and you will hear the voice of Yahweh." They stood there, about 300 in number. Moses set the fuses off, and it killed all of them. The imams got after Moses for performing this trick on the devils. Moses said to the imams, to the teachers, to the leaders, "If you only knew how much trouble these devils give me, you would do as I do." Moses taught the devils that if you would follow him and obey him, the Most High would give them a place amongst the holy people. Most of them believed Moses just to get out of the caves. The leaders recognized the tremendous job Moses had trying to civilize the savages, the enemies of the righteous people. of the righteous nation, well, of you so-called blacks, now had to take the places as the rulers and conquerors of the earth. The devils were given the knowledge and power to bring every living thing, regardless of its kind of life, into subjection. Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Now, Yahuwah said, let us make man in our images, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over everything on the earth creeping that creepeth upon the earth. And Yahuwah said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it. Book of Bereshit, Genesis 1 and 26 through 28. See, that quote right there was all necessary if the devils were to rule as gods of the world. They must conquer and bring into subjection all life on earth, not land life alone, but they must subdue the sea and the light therein, master everything, until a greater master of Yahuwah comes, which will mean the end of their power over life of the earth. We all bear witness that the scriptures quoted from Genesis refers to Ishua, Esau, mankind. They're the only people who answered the description and the word for the past 4,000 years. They've subdued the people and most every kind of living thing upon the earth. The Most High has blessed them to exercise all their knowledge and blessed them with gods that they call prophets from amongst our own people, with the rain and the seasons of the earth. Today's their wealth is great upon the earth. Their sciences of worldly goods have set them not only after the wealth of others than their own people, but even the lives and property of their own kind. They've tried to repeople, meaning replenish the earth with their own kind, but skillfully killing off the original people and mixing their blood into the original woman, the Asiatic black woman. But the job is too big for them to ever conquer. The original nation that they call the black nation, Yasha Allah, including its other three colors, brown, red, and yellow, outnumber mankind 11 to 1. See, Yahuwah created them in his image. The book of Bereshit 1 and 27, Genesis 20, 27. They're in the image and likeness of a human being, the original man, but are altogether different kinds of human beings than that of the original people. Their pale skin, their blue eyes, even disliked by themselves, tells any original man or woman that is in those blue eyes that there just can't be any sincere love and friendship for them. They are unlike, and we are like. Likes repel, unlikes attract. Their very characteristics of black and white are very different. The truth is never wanted by false believers. You understand? The people who have not known the truth must be taught it before judging them. This is right knowledge prevailing. I'm giving you the truth, and you should know the truth, and the truth will make you free. See, if a liar has deceived the people, then the truth will make manifest the liar. Yakub's race of devils were made unlike the original nation, the original people, the black nation, for the purpose of being able to attract the original nation to follow them. It stands true. White attracts black, and black attracts white. But where the attraction difference is that black, and especially the so-called Negro, love the unlike, the white race. While the unlike by nature can't love the so-called Negroes. As you've learned, they were made to hate and to kill off the original man. They've killed on average 100 million to every 1,000 years that they've been on our planet. 600 million. And hope to carry 97% of the so-called Negroes here in America to their doom. And 2/3 of the entire original population of the earth. Maybe a true knowledge of their enemies will reduce this figure. The devil has deceived us about the true and living. There is nothing to do with what he's taught us to believe in, what he calls God. It naturally doesn't exist. A spook for a God and a dead prophet of 2,000 years ago whom he wants you to believe is somewhat, somewhere in heaven, alive. Nothing could be worse, and the people believe it without any proof. I would like to make you prove such a false doctrine or suffer the consequences. There is no such thing as a heaven or hell for one to go to after death. This is one of the first lies that Yakub taught his made devils to teach to the people, you and me. Even to this day, there are millions of people believing such a lie. There are two conditions in our life, heaven and hell. Not beyond the grave. Death settles it all. According to the Bible, Bereshit, Genesis 3 and 20 through 24, Adam and his wife were the first parents of all the people. This is only referring to their race and the first sinners. Now, according to the word of Yahweh, he was driven from the Garden of Paradise into the hills and caves of West Asia that they now call Europe to live in the evil life in the West and not the Holy Land of the East. Therefore, Adonai, Yahuwah, sent him, Adam, from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from whence he was taken. So he drove out mankind and placed at the Garden of Eden cherubim, which was guards, a flaming sword, which turned every way to keep the devils out. The way of the tree of life, the sword prevented the Adamic race from crossing the borders of Europe and Asia to make trouble amongst the righteous for 2,000 years. After they were driven out of the Holy Land and the people for their mischief making, lying, disturbing the peace of the righteous nation. In your Quran it says, but the devil made them both fall from it and caused them to depart from that state in which they were. And he said, God set forth some of you being enemies of others, and there is for you in the earth an abode and a provision of time. Brothers and sisters, the time here refers to the limited time of the Adamic race. The time is 6,000 years, according to Genesis 2 and 36. They were driven out because they were the enemies of the people of the garden. In these words, get forth, some of you being enemies of others. The others cannot refer to any others than the people of the garden. The Adamic race is still the enemy of the righteous people, the original people. Nevertheless, the Most High did not deprive the Adamic race of right guidance through his prophets, whom they prosecuted and killed. The Adamic race, the mankind, history is a proof that they were the enemies of the Most High and the righteous, for they never did sincerely accept the prophets of the Most High. Can they now claim to be the chosen race of the Most High? Where is their proof? It is because they were allowed to rule for 6,000 years. If you are chosen, if you are the chosen race of the Most High, why would the Most High limit their time to rule? Why did the Most High send his prophets to warn them that he was going to destroy them? Go and read your Quran. Go and read your Bible. Those of you that read the Quran, you can read it in Surah 7 and 4. Musa said he's going to destroy them. You understand what I'm talking about? He said the devil respite me until the day when they are raised up. Those that are referred to as being raised up to the resurrection of the original man and to the knowledge of mankind as being the devils, the enemies of the Most High and the enemies of the original nation. He said the devil, as thou hast caused me to remain disappointed, I will certainly lie in wait for them in thy straight path. They said that in the Quran 7:166. See, what the Most High disappointed the devils in was the limiting of their rule over the nation and making them manifest to the wall of the original man that they're the enemies and the great deceivers of the righteous. See, mankind is not and never will be the chosen people of the Most High. They're the chosen people of their father Yakub, the devil. They're bold and shyless. They're pig eaters, alcohol drinkers, which help them make shameless, right? They go indiscreetly dress according to the Quran 7:17, 7:20, 21:26. It warns us of the shame with which these devils deceived our fathers in paradise 6,000 years ago. The devil led them out of the land of the isles into the Aegean Sea, stripped them of both clothing and covered their shame and wisdom and knowledge of themselves and the Most High. And today, the devils are playing the same trick on you and me, the whole of the original nation. The Holy Quran says, O children of Adam, we've indeed sent down to you clothing to cover your shame and clothing for beauty and clothing that guard against evil. That is the beast. This is of the messenger, that they may be mindful, not the devils. Mankind seduce you as he's expelled your parents from the garden, pulling them out of their clothing that they might show their shame. He sees you, he as well as his host, from whence you see them not. They're looking at you through electronic devices and so on and so forth. Surely he's made the devils to be the friends of the disbelievers. The Most High told me through the spirit of the Ruach HaKadosh that 6,000 years ago, the same people's fathers, mankind, broke the peace of the righteous in the Garden of Eden, the place that is known as Old Persia today. They called the truth of Yahuwah a lie and made lies the truth. They said that the people of the garden, according to the Bible in Genesis 3:4-6, and the serpent, a name used according to the evil, deceiving characteristics of mankind, said unto the woman, you shall not surely die, for Yahuwah doth know that in the day that you eat of it, your eyes shall come open and you shall be as gods. The serpent lied because they did lie. And the deceiver, the serpent, was driven out of the garden into the wilderness of the earth to build a wicked kingdom of evil to be destroyed on the coming of Yahuwah. The mankind are playing the same tricks on the original nation today as they did in the days of Adam. They shall suffer eternal explosion from the earth in a lake of fire. Read the book of Revelations 20:12. Can they enjoy peace? After they were cast out of the garden according to the Quran 7:16, because thou hast stoned me out of the way, lo, I will lie and wait for them on that straight way. As he had deceived Adam and his wife, he now declares that he will deceive the righteous in the straight path in the days of the resurrection and the judgment of his evil world. He swore to them in another place that he would lead them to a tree of immortality and a kingdom that decay not. This kind of teaching is found in the teachings of Christianity. It is a very clever way of deceiving the original people of America and throughout the world, for here Satan represents himself as an angel of light. They paint pictures of lies beyond the grave when they know that there's no life or communications with the dead. All ceases to be life after death. This is universally known. The awakening of the Arabs nearly 1400 years ago to the ancient truth, what was typical of what will be done today. He was opposed to the Arabs for a while, after the Arab nation and their country, he invaded as well. According to the past histories, the major prophets, one comes every 2,000 years until the end of the world of sin. Moses comes exactly 2,000 years after Yakub. Yakub is the God and the maker of mankind. Yahusha came 2,000 years after Moses. And the last prophet will come 2,000 years, fulfilling much of the histories of the prophets before him, especially Moses, David, Yahusha. Do you understand? The wise white scientists know it well as I, and hope to prevent it, but they are outnumbered by their wicked wise. See, Yahuwah created two kinds of everything. So it is with man. He didn't intend for the Negro or the so-called white man to mix, and has set a day of reckoning for those who willfully and knowingly break his natural law in which he has created man. It is their purpose to try and make the Most High as a deceiver, and to blind to the blind, deaf and dumb, so-called Negroes, as the devil deceived Adam and Eve in the Garden of Paradise. See, while knowing full well that they will lose their place with the Most High and a peaceful home if they accepted the advice. So, it will be with the so-called Negroes who, after being offered heaven once by the Most High, accepts the wicked advice and offers up a temporary enjoyment with racial intermarrying and having sexual intercourse with people with whom the Most High is angry. The original man had suffered from his mistakes and taken mankind for his friends. From that incident in Eden 6,000 years ago to this day, there's an enmity and a hatred between the people, black and white. This cannot be removed except by the removal of one or the other race. The two cannot come to and live up to a just agreement to do justice between each other. It is impossible unless their nature is changed. Adam and his wife accepted the advice of the devil against Adonai, and the serpent, the devils, has misled and put to death the prophets and the righteous servants of Yahweh ever since the fall of Adam. Ever since Adam, mankind, the Edomites, has been referred to as the man made, or the race of mankind. The world has taken it to include all men. No man have seen Yahweh, 1 John 5:19. This is another confused teaching amongst the ignorant masses. For if no man have seen Yahweh, then there is no God for you and me to look forward to seeing on the day of judgment. If such is true, how will we know him since no one has ever seen him? But we do know him and what he looks like. Adam, children, the great troublemaker, the demon, the fiend, Satan, the Adam's human beast, the hell raiser, the open arch enemy of Yahuwah, and all the original mankind who in the beginning disobeyed the laws of Yahuwah and introduced evil, filth, and disrespect from God and his laws of justice and righteous amongst the nation, a righteous people, are now on their traditional rampage against us, the so-called Negroes. They're good old slaves. They have been murdering and raping us throughout the centuries, yet you are foolish enough to love and adore them. devils. After all, their evils poured upon you and me. It just does not make any sense. Do not be surprised at anything like evil that you see them do. Only be surprised when you see them do an act of good in your favor. Evil is the nature of mankind and his children. They even have you believing that you're from mankind, which is absolutely false. Never say that you're from mankind. Mankind are the children of the devil and sin and disobedience. They was murderers from the beginning. You understand what I'm talking about?